Students, you open your copy and note down the spelling of subsidiary alliance. SUBSIDIARYALLIANCE. First, you have to know what is subsidiary alliance. This is a system, or this was a system developed by the East India Company, and it was imposed on the Indian rulers. There were many Indian territories, and rulers were there. They used to rule freely their kingdom, but through this alliance, British, they started interfering in their political or economic activities or economic system. Apart from that, they were compelled, those Indian rulers, they were forced by the British or the company to bear their expenditure or the expenditure of British force. This enraged the people of India, not only the peasants or Adivasis, even the rulers, even the common men, or entire people of India. This is the act it was imposed by British during that time. Apart from that, doctrine of lapse. When Lord Dalhousie, he became the governor of the time, he imposed doctrine of lapse. This was more harsh than subsidiary alliance. Through this act, it was a policy of annexation by the British. If any ruler, any landlord, zamindar, or any ruler of any small territory, if he dies without heir, that means without any descendant, if he dies, then his entire property or entire land will be seized by the British government. That was a policy of annexation. Thus, British annexed one by one, the territories, and later on they captured entire country. So, this is doctrine of lapse. It was imposed or introduced by Lord Dalhousie during that time. These two acts, that is under political cause. One more reason it was there during that time, Nana Saheb, he was the adopted son of Peshwa Bajirao II. Nana Saheb, he was denied his pension. British, they were not giving him pension. He was denied his pension and he was forced to migrate to Kanpur from Pune. After that, during that time, Bahadur Shah Zafar, he was the emperor, he was the throne of Delhi. So when they approached, British, they approached, after Nana Saheb, they approached Bahadur Shah Zafar, the agitation or the rebel or the revolt, it had spread like blazing forest. So the agitation or the revolt, it reached to its climax when Bahadur Shah Zafar also, he was also approached by British, he was also denied his pension. So these are the political causes of the rebel which began in 1857. Then let us come to the economic reason.